There, she is an incredible fast flyer. Now these top three for these medals is what we're looking at now. Ange Soltec took the silver medal last year. He didn't want that, he wanted that gold. It was a fight at the end between him and Cesar in this final round. Now with the top flyers, we're not even going to see the score or the time on the screen. We won't find out until the wind girls are in there with it. Emma, let's go back to the tunnel and check out the action of the final round of solo speed. Full house here. Everybody's down watching the action. Good afternoon, everybody here at Windsor. Some great shots of the crowd. Just resetting the system now, ready for the next flights. Let's go and check in with the crowd if I can, Emma. I don't know if I can get through. All right, we're trying to move through now and see what's going on down here, if possible. Emma, getting down. It's a busy, oh, there's a fight going on in the tunnel. It's running round and round. I can do that. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, Windsor. Oh, yeah, let's hear it. Come on. Make some noise. We want a Mexican wave starting over there, guys. He's going to start it rough. Rough, start the Mexican wave over there. Let's go. And it reads it through. And one more time, guys. One more time. Go. You. And one more for good luck. Go, guys. Go. Oh, yeah. Right, we're back to my seat. I can't cope with all this. Too much excitement. Ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it one more time for all the Windsor staff behind the scenes doing a great job. Let's hear it, come on. And let's hear it for all the judges here concentrating on all the action. Come on, let's hear it for the judges, guys. And one more big round of applause for all you people. Let's hear it. We are going back to the action. It's the final round of solo speed here at Wind Games 2019 with Emma Matacola and me, Regan Tetlow.
Regan's been out in the crowd doing his thing. So we have the news, which we did have before, but the top four, their times will not be shown. That will be Matteo, Cesar, Kaylee, and Ange. Their times will be hidden, keeping it a surprise for when the Wind Girls announce the winner live in the tunnel.
Well, this is it. This is the final of solo speed. Oh, Emma, I need a moment. Take over.
Right, okay, Regan. So after this round of solo speed, we will have the freestyle, but right now we have Oscar. Oscar is in the tunnel with one bust so far, a slight wobble there. This round is head up mixed snake. Butterfly up, and he's out of the tunnel. Well done, Oscar. That is Oscar's competition in solo speed complete.
Congratulations, Oscar. Thank you for joining us. He was here with a four-way this morning.
We have loved watching Oscar.
We really have.
Up next, Nikolai.
Nikolai Louis Kleflas. Kleflas. That's probably wrong. That's why we've not done it all day. Commentator tricks there for you.
And Nikolai's got his helmet on. He's ready.
Still to come, the final of the relay races and the final of the freestyle for open category.
Followed by the two-way dynamic finals. Nikolai looking good. Here is his head-up mixed snake. We did see head-up mixed snake in the previous round. There is Butterfly. Looks like that might have been a ring bust there. Into mixed circles. And two busts for Nikolai there. Completing those mixed circles. And out of the door.
With a time of 42.947.
So going in reverse order of how the rankings were yesterday. Nikolai up next will be Tomek. Tomek, who had to fly twice last time. He had to repeat his flight. This is Tomek from Poland. Into the tunnel. It all looks much better this time. No technical problems. Tomek is in. He's flying his head up, mixed snake. Into butterfly. Bottom loop on one side, bottom loop on the other. That looked like a ring bust. Into mixed circles. The flyer must perform mixed circles on one side of the tunnel, then on the other side before going over, under the ring and exiting the tunnel.
Out the door with a time of 39.231, Emma.
Okay. As we've seen it so far, the times are getting shorter as we go up the table. Not a surprise. We are going in order of the rankings, but the top four will be hidden this time to keep the suspense on who will be winning this discipline. Alabama Shanker in the tunnel now. This girl is going from strength to strength at the moment.
Izzy Squire says, come on, Ali, show them what you've got.
Amalia has joined us on the live stream. Ali flying like a ninja, mixed circles, completed on the other side of the tunnel.
And out the door she goes with a time of 34.623.
Up next, Elliot Pote from France.
Times are getting faster now. 3 seconds there, another 6 seconds there. What's Elliot going to put down?
Come on, Elliot. Final flight in this solo speed discipline in the Wind Games 2019. What a competition it's been so far, and it's not over yet.
That's right, yeah, we've got Elliot Porte now, 25 from France.
Hello to George Papadeus joining us from Bahrain. Elliot eagerly waiting for the wind speed to go up, waiting for the okay. His visor is down.
Here he is now. He's in the airflow.
Beginning with that head-up mixed snake. Into the butterfly. Bottom loop at one side. Bottom loop at the other side. Into mixed circles. He must perform this mixed circle at one side of the tunnel. Crossing over to the other side of the tunnel. Performing the mixed circle move again. Before exiting the tunnel.
Out he goes, 28.555.
A good score there from Elliot. Next up, it's Troy Rodway, 27 from Canada, showing us on his suit that Canadian flag, that Canadian pride.
There it is, there's the Canadian flag from Troy. Just waiting for the next bit of action. All the judges looking directly into the camera there.
Okay, judges are looking like they are ready. Oh, I can see on the judges' screen a little wave on the camera.
Yeah, judges, there's somebody waving at you on the camera. Yeah. There you go.
Okay, back to the action with Troy Rodway, 27 from Canada, bending down as he prepares to enter the tunnel. Little shoulder shrug, getting himself warmed up. These are athletes using their whole body to fly.
In the door he goes. Timer is on, Emma.
Head up mixed snake. Completing that snake into butterfly, crossover, bottom loop, crossover, bottom loop, into the mixed circles, which has a head down element and a head up element. transition over and again mix circles.
28.5 is the target on the clock right now. Should be beating that, but it's just over the pace actually.
So not quite as fast as Elliot there. That was a very good score from Elliot. Very fast flying. Theoretically, we should see these scores getting faster and faster as we move up the table. Next up, Léo Blanchon, age 24 from France.
28.555 is the current top speed.
Girlfriend Anna Cabré cheering him on, watching. Both nicely tanned from a trip to Bora Bora.
Looks like Alabama's going to get a refly at the end of this, Emma, but Léo is in the flow.
Yes, he is. Head up, mixed snake. And butterfly. Completing that butterfly into mixed circles. Finishing off those mixed circles, this is a fast round for Léo Blanchon of France. Looking very nice. Oh, he's got one burst.
Out the door with 31.374.
Very frustrating because that would have put him in the lead had it not been for that burst.
Next up is going to be Kirapo. Let's check out a very distinctive entrance into the tunnel. We know we've mentioned it a few times in joking way, the bobsleigh look, but it is just like that. That very quick speed run through the door is what she takes. We've got a review taking place right now on the screen. Keep your eye when we get Kira from Singapore in the door and to see her technique as she enters the tunnel, eking out every bit of athletic advantage to start that run.
Yeah, it looks like a sideline bust for Léo. Just clarification from the judges there. Looked like it might have been his foot. Kira Po, age 16 from Singapore. As Regan mentioned, we've got that fantastic start, that entrance to the tunnel. That's what Regan called a bobsleigh entrance.
Yeah, just like when you see the guys on the bobsleigh when they're about to start the run, they've got to run as get as much speed as quickly as possible. It's a very similar technique. Let's watch how she does it. There she is. Watch that run. Bam, she's in.
That's in. That's a great start. A running start. Fast start from Kira Po from Singapore.
Wow,
butterfly.
She's flying as hard as she can here.
She is. She's giving it everything she's got in this solo speed event. She will still be competing in the relay races, so this competition is not quite over for her after this round.
And out the door. Great time. 26.599. 2 seconds faster than the previous fastest.
Okay, so Kira showing us how it's done there. Almost 2 seconds faster than Elliot. Next up, Lewis Hard of Great Britain, one of the instructors here at Windsor.
Incredible to be 2 seconds faster on such a short race, Emma. Here we go, Lewis Hard is in.
He is in. There's the head-up mixed snake. Pushing off the walls, giving himself more power. Beautiful body position here from Lewis Hard. He makes it look so, so, so easy.
26.599, Emma, is his target.
Reverse circles on the other side of the tunnel.
Needs to get himself through that door. Just over the time, 27.260.
Kira Po still in the lead at the moment as this rate, as the ranking stand thus far.
At the top, Andre Soltek is almost 2 seconds in front of Keila Wittenberg from the USA. It's a lot to ask. The scores are going to be hidden from those top flyers, Emma.
Yes, they are. Looks like a review going on. Is it?
Yeah,
no,
it's a review right
I
now.
I think it is one of the instructors just fixing the net at the bottom of the tunnel. And a slow-mo of Lewis flying his socks off. Hello to Maud, Tane, and Muzz who've joined us in the live stream.
There, the ominous button for the relay races is in shot as our next flyer, Noah Robert Rocket Harold Howard Wittenberg.
Oh, he's left.
Runs back in again. Oh, he's trying to touch the wall, I think, in the time it takes me to say his name.
Possibly Regan. He likes to get himself warmed up, visor down, no messing about.
Leading forward.
Noah.
There you go. Charging in. Timer on.
Head up, McSnake. Next up will be Butterfly.
Time to beat is 25.999.
Whoa, Noah. I'm not sure what happened there. It was some kind of roll against the wall, but it did not affect his speed.
Oh, out the door. 26.283, a new top speed.
Wow, Noah Wittenberg, look at that. Look at that roll, saving himself on those mixed circles. Greg Crozier saying, well done, Lewis. Danny Gallego, 24 from Spain, is next up to fly in the solo speed. Here is Danny. He is in. He's looking good. Head up McSnake here into Butterfly. Bottom loop at one side of the tunnel. Crossover. Bottom loop at the other side. He's incurred a penalty. That will be 3 seconds added onto his final time. Mixed circles. Completing those mixed circles. Over, under, out. With one burst.
Oh, wow. 29.611 for Danny Gallego in the final round of solo speed.
That looks like it would have been putting him third in the rankings so far, if not for that burst. This is where you just don't want to burst. You don't want to see those red lights because it is time added onto your final score.
Is it going to stand or is there a review of that burst going on right now? Ishan Chu is ready. Oh, a big deep breath. She set the top speed the previous round.
Ishan had an amazing last round. It was still not quite enough to get her out of that fifth position. She may or not be able to this time.
Come on, Ishan. Yeah, she's fixed and knows what she needs to do. Incredible concentration, visor down, making sure the chin strap is done and she's in. Come on, everybody, make some noise for Singapore.
Ishan Chu showing us how it's done. Beautiful butterfly into mixed circles. Next will be mixed circles on the other side of the tunnel. We're getting closer to the top of the leaderboard here. The next four, we will not see their scores.
Out the door, 27.730.
Looks like that will put her fourth on the leaderboard at the moment, although not overall. I've got a feeling she's going to hang on to that fifth place. We will now not see any more scores, although we do have a reflight at the end of this round from FSU Alabama Shanker due to a technical issue. Mateo Limnaeus here, ready to fly. We won't see the clock on screen now. Hello to Dave Heinemann, who's just joined us. Mateo nervously watching. We will see his rounds, but we won't see his time. Looks like we are seeing his time on the screen.
Yeah, so his time is currently on screen.
So, Mateo looking good. He's looking very fast. We know he's a very fast flyer. Completing those mixed circles, and he's out.
It's 26.828.
A very fast one there from Mateo. Currently in fourth position, Mateo. Cesar, we are now going to see him fly.
Cesar Rico takes a seat. Wind speed drops down. Haley Wittenberg takes a seat next to him.
Andrzej Soltik will be the third one in the tunnel. It's going to be Cesar, Kaylee, then Andrzej. Then we will see a reflight from FSU, Alabama Shanker. There is such a good atmosphere between the competitors in this competition. Does not matter where you are from, what age you are. Everybody is friends here, and it is so good to see the support, the loyalty, the friendships. This is part of what makes these competitions so very special.
It is indeed. Last year's gold medal champion of the solo speed event, Cesar Rico, eyes up the next half a minute in his mind as he shakes it out and prepares, and Andrzej Soltik just behind the window waiting for his moment to clinch the gold medal. Here we go, speed on.
And he's in. This is looking good. Completing his butterfly. Next up will be mixed circles. Transition to the other side of the tunnel, mixed circles. Finishing those off and...
out the door, flying hard, 26.658. Cesar Rico from Spain. His last flight in solo speed is behind him.
Up next, in the hands of Kaylee Wittenberg from the USA, age 14, closing her eyes, visualizing what it is that she's got to do.
Currently in second place, 2 seconds off the lead. Nothing's impossible, but wow, it's a big, big ask for the American. Here we go.
She is in, starting with that head-up mixed snake. Completing that into butterfly. That is very fast, Regan.
It is indeed.
Mixed circles. First one of the mixed circles. Transition to the other side of the tunnel. Second mixed circles. Completing the head-up part.
Come on, get out the door. Here she goes. Oh, she's done it. So we'll just leave the time to you watching at the moment. It is on the screen. We did think it was going to be in secret, but on the screen it is. One more flight.
Okay, that was Kaylee Wittenberg flying from the UK. Andrzej Soltik up next, age 17 from Poland.
All right, now for this championship. So it's still one flight to go by Alabama Shanker, but now for the championship flight from Poland, as the red lights flash, just sorting out a few technical issues with the tunnel.
Bit of fluff caught in the bottom of the tunnel there, I think. Up next will be Andrzej Soltik, seeing if he can retain that current 2 second lead at the top of the leaderboard. He's been flying phenomenally fast. What is his secret? What does he eat for breakfast? Andrzej from Poland. We cannot wait to see him fly in the final round of solo speed.
He took the silver medal last year against Cesar Rico. Down to the wire it was, fractions of a second. He's dominated for the last couple of rounds on this solo speed event. He's maturing as an athlete and as a flyer. Gone are the jokey, laughy days. As he waits there, we saw a couple of years ago, now it's game face in serious from the pole.
Very serious face there from Andrzej Soltik. This is no game. This is serious business. This is the Wind Games 2019. This is the final of solo speed, and that gold medal is in his clutches. 8 rounds flown already. This is the 9th and final round. The decider, will he get that gold medal? A nervous wait for Andre now. Soon he will be able to put his visor down, get himself into the tunnel. Visor is down, he is in. Head up, McSnake. Going very, very fast into butterfly. Looking very nice and clean here. Mixed circles completed on one side of the tunnel. Transition to the other side of the tunnel. Mixed circles here too. Looking good. Andre Soltik, can he retain that gold medal? And he's out of the door with a time of 28.122. Looks like he may have sustained an injury there. He's clutching his ankle. Rolling on the floor. That was an incredibly fast exit from Andre. Oh, he's looking like he is in pain. Dad there, just making sure he is okay. This is a very high speed event. And sometimes these injuries do happen. He is holding his ankle.
Yeah, his mother and father are there with him. Emma at the side of the tunnel right now, just to see how he is. We're getting him up on his feet. And they're helping him hobble out through the door. We still have one more flight to go, the reflight for Alabama. We've got some ice packs heading into the tunnel right now. Very shortly, we're going to be announcing the winner of this solo speed, Emma.
So this is a very fast event, Regan. We've seen that anything can happen. Andre is in the antechamber now, it looks like. Shortly, we will see the results being announced, but obviously the health of the competitors is absolutely top priority here.
Fractions of a second, Emma, hundredths of a second between the top four in this event is what we've been seeing. But right now, we've still got one more flight to go from Alabama Shanker from the UK.
Judges just seem to be reviewing Kaylee Wittenberg's video. Nervous wait to see what's going to happen. We do not know what the final scores are for these top four competitors, so we will be waiting for the Wind Girl to announce this. Now comes Alabama Shanker. She's getting ready for her reflight. Alabama seems to always fly after there's been some kind of drama. She's flown twice after Fred. So Ali, getting ready, getting her visor down. A little shake of the head. Age 19 from Great Britain, Alabama Shanker has huge support here at the tunnel and on the live stream. Lots of Basingstoke sending their love, sending their best wishes for her. an exciting event. The final competitors to fly in this solo speed event before we announce the winners via the Wind Girl in the Tunnel, Alabama Shanker, Flying Head Up Mixed Snake, Butterfly, and Mixed Circles. What an event. Looks like she's been given the green light to go. She is in the tunnel. Beginning with Head Up Mixed Snake. Into the Butterfly. Bottom loop on one side of the tunnel. Bottom loop on the other side. Mixed Circles. Stalling it back. A fast transition to the other side of the tunnel where she will begin her second Mixed Circles. Stalling back, over, under, out! Alabama Shanker with a score of 34.688. The table is hidden from the side of the screen at the moment as we are keeping the results.
So we're going to go to the result of the solo speed. We've got the Flyers here. We've got the Wind Girls as well. We're going to get them in the tunnel. An incredible flight by all these competitors. Not without controversy, down to the wire with Andre crashing down full speed as he came out. He's still there now. Smile on his face, a twisted ankle, I think is what we've got, Emma. We don't know the final scores. We know it was 2 seconds between Kaylee Wittenberg and Andre Soltek. With two rounds to go, the final round has flown. And we're going to find out very shortly just what the result is. People of Window, can you hear me? You can. The mic's working out there, is it? Just about? Yeah, it is. Okay, we know we're good to go. Wind Girls, are you ready? Are you sure? Andre, can you walk? Yeah. Come on. First of all, let's get a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get you in here with me. Come on. Dude. My t-shirt's rising up.
I can't hear you.
How was the crash? How was that crash?
Well, intense. Well, it will sound stupid, but I was thinking that I was running, but I wasn't. I really wasn't running and I just hit the door. That's it.
Very loud in here with the wind still flying. Can we come down a little bit with the wind maybe? Let's check in with Kaylee Wittenberg. Wow, do you think you've done enough?
I don't know. It's tight.
It's tight at the top. Matteo, fast.
Yeah, it's cool.
And Dario Cesar, last year's winner, Muchacho. Wow.
Yeah, this year was even more hard than last year. And let's see what happened, but we have really good competitors, really good flyers. And we hope to next year will be better, even better.
We're going to find out. We are moments away. Can you still hear us out there? Yes, can you hear us? We're not sure if they can or not, actually, with the wind speed on us. But judges, are we ready with the result? Are we ready? The champion of solo speed at Wind Games 2019 is Andre Soltek, ladies and gentlemen.
What's that?
How do you feel?
Really good, really good. Well, my leg is a little bit not okay. But I feel just intense.
Intense, he says, ladies and gentlemen. One more big round of applause. We'll see you all later. And we're going for the second place now. Okay, we're going to find out who is second and third shortly, Emma.
And Windor, hashtag more than a tunnel. It's always been about the community with Windor, and one of the things they're doing at this Rain Games is raising money for those less fortunate than ourselves. So competitors, judges, people online, we're all putting in to help two good causes, the Antonio Cabret Foundation and the Carol Foundation. So I've got here Will Penny and Allegra Nazzi from the Carol Foundation. So just like to ask you, Will, what does the foundation actually do?
Hey, Leslie, thank you for having us here today. The foundation has a series of actions that we support. One of them is related to skydiving. Actually, we just introduced a new one. So we have two actions that are related towards the flying community. And we also help a whole bunch of other people around the world for humanitarian and solidarity purposes, like education and helping people to basically just have a better life and a more fortunate start, let's say, to projects or education. So it's quite a new take on a foundation. We're not just working with one action, which most foundations do. It's kind of like a progressive way to incorporate a whole bunch of different actions. So we're quite fortunate with that.
So you're 1 year into the foundation. You've been going a year. Tell me about the first year, Allegra.
Well, it's been an incredible satisfaction, and it's been amazing actually to see everybody coming together, like the people, Windor, who we have to thank, because not only in this occasion, but they've been a fundamental partner. I mean, they've made a lot of what we've done possible. I had high expectations and beliefs in this project, and it exceeded them. So the Sky Family Fund has helped three people. We have managed to pay for school for some kids. We've managed to help an orphanage. We've actually done some good, and honestly, we're a year old, so I'm very, very happy so far.
So how can people get involved in the fund?
You can obviously donate to the foundation. We allow people to choose where they want to donate. So you can choose the whatever action you prefer. So that's one way. And then obviously we're here. Here you can donate via the link, the Windor's link. And so participate in the now and donate whenever you so feel inclined to do on our website.
And so the Sky Family Fund, that's about helping injured skydivers, is it? Tell me a little more.
Yeah, Leslie, that's pretty much exactly it. Like, the Sky Family Fund was created by our community for our community, so it's working specifically with people who've been injured in skydiving or base jumping accidents. And we did a really nice fundraising event last year for the Sky Family Fund, the Sky Family Fundraiser, actually, it was called. And we managed to raise over 18,000 euros. And we've actually helped three people directly who've been really seriously injured in accidents. And at the same time, reached out to a whole bunch more, like about another six or seven people who were involved in accidents. So it's already effective. It's already working. We've already made a positive difference to a few people's lives. And there's definitely a huge thank you to our community for supporting the idea, for supporting us, for believing in us, and standing behind us with this, what we like to consider quite a groundbreaking way to think a little bit bigger behind what we're doing. And we're very fortunate to have an amazing partnership with Windor during the Wing Games, and they really support our idea from the beginning. And I think, you know, in our community, you've been in the game for a long time too. A lot of the time things are working for their own purpose. So what we're trying to do is at least show how we can do something really awesome for sports, but at the same time give a little bit back. So we're trying to add another layer to what we're doing, make it have a deeper meaning. And it's been really amazing that Windor has embraced that, and they've been an incredible partner of ours since the beginning. So we're very fortunate for that, and also for the community that's behind us. You know, this, we couldn't have got this far if it wasn't for the generous donors, the people that we go to for support or to give us ideas. So once again, a huge thank you to everyone who's believed in us and the foundation. Yeah, thank you very much on behalf of the Carol Foundation.
Okay, and last question. Allegra, it's been great to hear about what you've done so far, helping so many people. What are we going to see in the future?
We have a bunch of plans of fundraising actions, both for the non-flying causes. And for the flying, we have, obviously, we'll have another Sky Family fundraiser next year in November. And very soon, we'll give you guys information, because we have a very special and very ambitious new project, which is to offer the gift of flight, which we all have the privilege of seeing how it affects us. So to offer this to 150 kids of our province who are in underprivileged conditions, and do a selection and offer a scholarship to arrive to a tunnel instructor degree, which obviously opens doors and helps create possibilities for better lives.
That's fantastic. And what's your website address if people want to find out more?
www.carolfoundation.org.
Donate. www.carolfoundation.org. Thank you very much for talking to us, and I wish you all the best with the foundation. Donate.